Hey there, folks. This video has been long overdue, and I've been tinkering about it for close to a year at this point. I'm so glad I finally managed to complete it. So this is going to be part one of a two-video segment on how to use NMAP and the NSE script engine to enumerate targets within industrial control systems. Each and every script is coupled with a shodan dork to find the corresponding target, and we'll start with PC Works, which is a very popular ICS programming software used for developing control logic and configuring systems in the manufacturing and automation industries. As you can see here, we find over 700 targets, most of which have the ICS tag as well. Now, this first script is called PCWorks-info and defaults to port 1962. We can give it a second to run, and as you can see, the output includes the service running. We got information like the PLC type, the model running underneath, firmware version, date and time for firmware updates. Now, we can clear up the terminal in a second and move on to the next one real quick. So the next one is going to be Niagara Fox, which runs on port 1911 and is a very common ICS protocol used for basically communication and management automation in control systems. Now we can check out the Google Dork. And as we wait for this to finish, I'll give you a few more words about Niagara Fox. So these are commonly used in building automation and control systems for HVAC, for lighting, security, and energy management. And they typically use the Tritium Niagara framework, which is very scalable and extensible. Now, we can copy this NMAP script here. And you saw we found like a lot of potential targets. We can paste it here. And so right here, you can see that we get the default port, which is 1911. We get information about the Fox version, host name, the host address, the app name, versions, the name of the virtual machine, which is very juicy stuff, and the time zone, which is in New York in this case, and also host ID. Now, real quick, we can move on to the next one. Now, this one is actually a script that we did try in a previous video, and that would be the modicon-info script for Modbus devices, which runs by default on port 502. Now, the shodan dork is very simple. We just go for port 502 Schneider, which is the vendor's name, and we get a whopping 2,700 hits on this one. We can try it out and see what we get. So this one is the NMAP script. We just need to specify the name of the script, which is modicon info, and the port as well, which is 502, as we just said. We get, again, a lot of very useful info. We get the name of the protocol, which is Modbus, of course. Vendor name, we get the network module, CPU modules, version of firmware, we get the ID for the memory card, and information on the project as well. So, in short, there's a lot of stuff that could be used offensively in the hands of an adversary. So, another super useful module is one for Siemens S7 PLCs. Now, the shodan dork is quite simply S7, and on this one, we'll just give it a sec, we're going to get a lot of hits. As you can see, there's close to 2,500 hosts that run on Siemens S7. Now, some of these are honeypots, as you can see. Others are hosted in the cloud. Now, we have two different scripts for S7 PLCs. Now, we'll start with the S7-enumerate script, specifying the default port for S7 PLCs, which is 102. And we can also append the SV flag to enumerate services. Now, you can see that this script runs both modules and enumerates information relating to hardware versions, serial numbers, etc. Now, you can see here that we get again, the default port, we get modules, hardware versions, and all types of goodies. Now, for good measure, we can try out the info script, which has a more concise output. So what we can do is that we can run it once again, and we can remove the SV flag to kind of speed up the process as well, so that NMAP is not as slow. Now we can jump right into the final NMAP script for this video, and that would be the inip-info NSE script. We can start off by finding targets on Shodan with this dork right here for Rockwell Automation, Alan Bradley. So as we wait for this to finish, a few more words on port 44A1A, which is commonly used to enumerate Ethernet IP devices, including those manufactured by Alan Bradley, which is a brand owned by Rockwell Automation. Now, this time we got over 3,800 OST, so we can try out the NMAP script. We can paste it here, and as you can see, we got lots of information once again about vendor names, serial numbers. We even got, as you can see here, we even got an internal IP address. So lots of stuff. This would be it for now. As I said before, this video has been long overdue, and I do hope you guys have enjoyed it. Like always, I advise you against doing anything malicious with this information and only use it as part of sanctioned engagements. You guys let me know what you think down below in the comment section, and I'll see you in part 2.